Prisons are designed to keep inmates in, but some prisoners at a Fayette County minimum security prison have been getting out. So far this year, Blackburn Correctional Complex has had as many escapes in 6 months as they typically see in a year. Our Mark Barber sat down with a veteran correctional officer at the prison who's concerned about the escapes because he says many of the inmates are walking away hours before the community is ever alerted.
Now, there's no escorted movement at all.
About 1,700 inmates are assigned to Blackburn Correctional Complex each year. The inmates are all sentenced to less than 4 years, but they don't all serve the time.
They simply just walk off the property.
The only thing standing between the inmates and freedom are 6-foot wood fences, but those only separate the prison from these two neighborhoods here that run off of Spur Road. On the other side of the property, inmates are greeted with wide open fields that lead right up to I-64. According to prison data obtained by WKYT, in the previous 5 years, an average of 5 inmates escaped from the prison on Spur Road each year. Prison documents show that 5 inmates have already escaped this year.
That is the reality of it. This is a minimum custody facility. There's no fences here. There's no guarantee that these guys won't walk off.
This veteran employee of Blackburn asked us to frame him in shadows and change his voice. He doesn't want to be identified because he has safety concerns. He thinks the escapes are tied to the warden's decision to give inmates an extra hour in the yard each night.
Escapes lately have just went skyrocketed because of that.
Just wanted to give them an extra, especially this time of year when it doesn't start getting dark until around 9 p.m.
State documents show that some inmates have been using the extra hour as an opportunity to walk out, not work out. 12 of the 18 escapes since then were reported after 8 p.m. After discovering 4 of those escapes this year, the Department of Corrections sent alerts to the media and the public, saying the inmates walked away between 9 and 10 p.m.
Impossible. Impossible. There's no way that could happen. That's when they discover them missing. And that's what they're not telling the public. And they can make their getaway anytime. And it's usually after the 6 p.m. count is cleared.
By the time officers realize they're an inmate short, the missing inmate may already have a 3-hour head start on them.
The neighbors are being lied to. They could be in their yard. They could be in their house doing something. We would never know anything about it. They could actually jump back over the fence after they did something and be back in the dorm by 9 p.m. They'd be in Cincinnati by the 9 o'clock count.
In 2011, Anthony Kendrick and Jerry Nation walked away from Blackburn, stole a car in Scott County, burglarized a home in Shelby County, and then led police on a chase in Spencer County. They were captured 6 months later when a tip led U.S. Marshals to their hideout in Texas.
They do have people that have committed murder, burglaries, very violent burglaries, and they're serving out the last of their sentences.
Well, it would be concerning if I thought we weren't doing our job and doing the things that we have in place to prevent it from happening.
Haney says he doesn't think adding another inmate count before 9 p.m. or putting up fences is necessary because it's a minimum security prison. The officer who worked here for more than 5 years says if it's too easy for inmates to walk off and too hard to notify people about escapes quickly, something has to change.
There needs to be a new administration in there. Yard needs to be shut down earlier. Fences need to be put up. And neighbors need to be aware of what's going on there, what's really going on.
We wanted to get some perspective on the number of escapes at Blackburn, so we asked the Department of Corrections how many inmates were escaping from prisons in other states. In Tennessee, they say they had 4 escapes from minimum security prisons since 2013. Prison officials in Virginia say they haven't had an inmate escape in several years. And in Ohio, officials didn't have recent numbers, but they say from 2011 until 2013, they only had 5 escapes. In the newsroom, Mark Barber, WKYT.
We started checking into the escapes after people who live near the prison started raising some questions. We asked police for data that would show if there have been any break-ins or other crimes in the area tied to escapes. They said they couldn't give us that information because they'd have to search through each and every one of their cases.